Hello, everybody. Welcome to another edition of X-keys 5-Minute Friday. I am Dan, and you may notice my co-host Miranda is conspicuously absent here. She has day off. I'm sorry, you're stuck with me. So let's see here. The next thing we want to do is talk about our streaming setup. We're going out to YouTube at 1080p, 29.9 frames per second, 6 megabits per second. Important stuff here is that we're using vMix Pro version 21. We're using a PTZ Optics USB 20X camera provided by our good buddies over at PTZ Optics. We have upgraded to a new X-keys mouse mat. It's bigger and thinner than the original, and it's performing admirably here. Using vMix Social on our Kindle. The biggest thing I want to show you is our X-keys XKE 124 T-bar with a video key switcher set on it, which is what I'm controlling this show from here today. And I'm not going to bore you with everything else. You can freeze frame on that and look at all the details or ask us about it if you want to. Today, I'm really pretty geeked about this. We, for the longest time, especially at NAB, people would come up to the booth and say, I've got an ATEM and I'd really like to be able to control that with an X-keys. How can I do it? And I haven't had a good, simple answer for them. It's like, yes, you can use third-party software like Just Macros, or there's a couple other places out there, but you have to be somewhat of a programmer to get those set up and running. So I was really excited when Robert approached me at IBC this year and told me he was working on this new project. And I can't tell you any more about it because I'm not that techie about it, but I asked our good buddy TJ Thompson to evaluate it for us. He's been doing that, and that's what he's doing today, is telling us all about it. So, hey, TJ.
Hey, are you there? How are you?
I'm good. Here. Good. I see our connection's a little fuzzy at the moment, but it's kind of been coming and going this morning. So, this is TJ. TJ, I'm just going to toss it over to you and you can run us through everything. I got to get the right input up here. Sorry, my TD is not here, so doing it myself. Let's try that again.
All right, hopefully this cleans up a little bit for you guys, and we can work through this. We'll see if it cleans up. I'll do some things here to try to make it a little better for y'all. So the first thing I want to show you is exactly what we're working with. So this is actually the kind of our fly pack that we use, and that's the ATEM right there. So the way this is working is we've got a vMix machine running down there, an ATEM, all of our camera sources hit a router. So that's what we're going to be looking at. We're going to be looking at the ATEM coming into the vMix machine, and the vMix machine is running the ATEM software as well. That's the router up there. So that's what we're going to go to next. Let me go ahead and pull up a desktop capture here so we can see everything.
TJ, you know what I forgot to mention at the head of this thing is the name of the software. It's called PresetMaster. I think the link's in the YouTube description. So,
yeah, it's PresetMaster. It's right there. Hopefully you guys can see it. I'm not monitoring the stream, so I'll trust that it looks good. So what we've got up here is our ATEM control software, vMix running in the background, so you can see this is actually the output of the ATEM. I'll just confirm that. We'll put some bars up here with a cut, so you can see that's the ATEM output. And then this is PresetMaster down here. This is where the magic happens. So this is kind of the interface between the X-keys and the ATEM software. Robert has developed some awesome stuff over at PresetMaster to allow us to take the SDK within the Blackmagic software and kind of fire it with this preset master. When you open it up, it looks like this, basic kind of file management stuff. This is a recent file that I built just for the demo. We're going to click right over into Vices real quick, and I'll pull this up so we can see what's happening. So in your devices, this is where you can add a new device, or you can connect to a device you already have, which I'm already connected to my ATEM. This shows the list of devices that he has available right now. So what's cool about this is this software can control multiple devices at the same time with an X-keys panel. So you could, you know, throw a hyperdeck into record or send a command to your switcher all with one button push, and it's all kind of housed within these presets. It's super neat. I'm not going to go too into detail about how to set some of this stuff up because there's some great videos on Preset Master's page you can check out. But let's just work with our ATEM right now. I'm going to delete this device here. So you can see we have our ATEM. It says that it's connected. Blackmagic Design Switcher, I named it an ATEM, and then this is my IP for where it's living. If we jump over here into presets, now you're saying, I just built a whole show. Where are all the presets that I just built? Well, we have to first select the device that you want to control and the device that you've built your presets for. I've built my ATEM presets. So if I click on ATEM, boom, all of them come right back up. To add a preset, I'm just going to delete this bars one. Let's make a bars one. So let's add a preset here. It pulls up a new button. I'm going to label this bars. It's going to be a program button, right? I want it to take it to program. And then I'm going to make my input color bars. There we go. I'm going to hit save. All right. So now we've created a preset that if we select the preset right, it goes to color bars. Well, you kind of have to go one more step, which is good. It's going to seem weird if you're only doing one button push, but you'll understand why. Jump over here to scenes. And now what you're going to do is you're going to take and add the preset that you have and make a scene out of it. It sounds weird, but just kind of hang with me for one sec. So if we add a scene here, I'm going to call it bars. And I'll make it, let's make it red. Oh, also, this is a side note. I love the colors that this guy has chosen. Dodger blue, deep sky blue. There's some good ones in here. Light salmon, medium aquamarine. So if you're OCD about colors, mighty rose, mint cream, Navajo white. Yeah, you should be able to find a color in here. So, all right, so now we've created a scene. This is not a button. This doesn't do anything. It's just a well that's going to hold a bunch of presets. This would be cool if you wanted to do the multiple triggering that I was talking about. So let's say you wanted to kind of create a macro, so to speak, like on a switcher that would, you know, take input 2 with key 1 and it'll take it to program with X transition. You could add all these presets in here and do that with a flick of a button. We're just going to make it easy, add our preset for bars, which you'll see under our device and bars. It's there. I'm going to click save and it makes our little button. Now that we have our scene made, our scenes are all going to show up in our live panel. So I'm going to go over here to our live panel and you can see this is all the different scenes that we created. Now this area is pretty cool. You can add a new button and you can actually come in here and make these different shapes. You could maybe make this the shape of your X keys layout. You can change the font colors, the backing colors, the border. You can change the name. You can do a little bit of everything. I mean, it's really neat what you can do in this live panel. You can just customize it however you want. But this is where the magic happens with X keys. Once you click on one of these buttons, you'll see that down here in the bottom, you have a hotkey selection. So I'm just going to hit edit. And now I'm going to press, let me see if I can show this to you. I got a little X key here. I'm just going to press button number 3 for program. We're just going to make that bars right now. So it finds it. It actually gives me a backlight option. I'm just going to make it red and switch to red. And now I'm going to hit save. Once I have it saved, this show is running. It says over here in the right that our ATEM is active. So if we look over here at our control panel and we hit our button 3, it's going to take bars to program. So if we hit button 2, which I have programmed as camera 2 to program, it's going to be black. Camera 1 is the camera that's feeding the ATEM. So that's all through this guy right here. I'm going to just put camera 1 in here and I'm going to show you that I even have the mix transitions. It's not doing anything because I have camera 1 in programming preview because I want you to be able to see the controller. But you can see the T-bar there. We even have control of the downstream keys. So like if you wanted to add a score bug and a replay bug, those are all controllable in here. The only hiccup at this point that I have found with this software is with the keys. To get these keys to work, they don't show up in Preset Master. Like if you were gonna go in here and create a new preset, you don't see any key buttons in here. but you do have macro buttons. So all I did to get the keys in here was I just created some simple macros within the ATEM for a downstream key on, downstream key, one auto, downstream two auto. So that's how I got the macros to work. So that's it. It's a great software that I'm keeping on this machine to run our fly pack with our X keys. I really, really enjoy what it's been able to do. And I can't wait to actually map it to the full X keys T-bar. I think that's going to be super cool. Right now, I've just kind of, like I said, I've just been testing it on my smaller X keys here. But once I get the T-bar implemented and a TD can sit down and actually have full control of the ATEM, just like they're looking at a broadcast panel, it's just going to be life-changing for those guys. So that's it.
That is terrific. And TJ, thanks. We're beyond our 5 minutes, of course. Knew it was gonna happen today. But we're gonna wrap it, and we're gonna come back and take questions in the post show. TJ, I know you're really busy, and I really appreciate you taking the time out of your day to come show us this program. And I'll have more information too in the post show. So if I find the right button here, there you go. We'll be right back. Okay. So the thing that I like about what you were showing me, and again, you know, we've got other solutions. There's one out there for PowerShell. There's one out there. There's Just Macro has been out there for a long time, and there are a lot of people using that, and it's very reliable for them. But you've got to learn some programming before you can set that thing up. And to me, this looked like something I could actually be able to come in and use pull down menus and assign things and get it up working without having to learn Lua script or without having to learn PowerShell.
The interface is fantastic on it. It's laid out pretty well. It seems redundant with the scenes and presets step. Like when I first did, I was like, why am I doing this just to make a simple input? But then once mm-hmm. you understand that he's trying to build in all this complexity to it so that you have these options to do whatever, it makes complete sense. And the fact that he's already promising, you know, to go out and search for different devices that can be controlled all through Preset Master is phenomenal. So I know I'm going to push. I haven't told him this. I'm going to tell him right now. So, Robert, I know you're asleep, but I want you to create and dissect the SDK for the Blackmagic Design routers. One of the things, like in that photo I showed you, we have the Blackmagic push button router selecting, and X-keys makes these awesome little rack units that I would love to be able to stick in front of a replay operator or a producer that could just control their monitor wall or what camera inputs they're bringing into the vMix replay. So if we had a goal cam on the far end of the field, they could just bring in that goal when they're headed that way or vice versa, and not have to, you know, invest a lot of money in these Blackmagic panels when the X keys would do a fantastic job of that. So I'm not saying you should do it.
Cool. I think I put the URL in the show notes. If not, I'll go back and put it in. It's presetmaster.nl. Robert's a cool guy. I've liked working with him. And I really haven't had a whole lot of interaction because he's just taken it on himself and done it. It's not free. He's got a free version, trial version that's kind of limited. And then he's got a couple different tiers depending on how many inputs and how many devices that you need to control. So go check it out. I'm just really happy that now I've finally got an answer to that question when somebody says, how can I control ATEM with my X keys? And I'm not a programmer, you know? So this looks like it's going to be a really solid solution for somebody like that.
Yeah. It's really interesting actually when I've gone back, like, and it's like a 3-month journey when I'm like, man, I really want to control the ATEM. And then I always go look at just macros and get super frustrated and walk away. And then it's like 3 months later, I come back and I'm like, all right, I'm going to take the time to dive into it. And it's not that it's too hard to understand. It just takes time to get in there and learn. Like if you're not familiar with the coding stuff, it takes a minute to get that.
Yeah, there does seem to be a pretty steep learning curve with that. And I don't feel like I can recommend something that I can't do myself. So I'll be messing around with this. And it looks like your stream froze on us, TJ. There aren't any more questions in the chat here for you. So I'm, again, going to say I really appreciate you taking the time to be with us. It's a tough looking face you got there. And we're going to say goodbye. And I hope we see you next Friday. Thanks, guys.